Hey everyone. This is John. We're here with a late Halloween edition. One last week of Halloween themed games here on Team Brothership.
Yeah, this is the video game equivalent of like the final jump scare where you think the killer's dead and then suddenly he just like lunges out from under the sheet where the coroners were carrying him away.
Hands you a big bag of candy.
Exactly. But then you open the bag and a monster jumps out and bites you.
Perfect.
Yeah.
I think it's more the equivalent of the, it's the video game equivalent of the post-credits teaser, because after this, there's tons more mediocre content to follow.
That's fair enough.
But this is Deathsmiles. Fantastic little game from 14 years ago.
Jeez. Ugh. Yeah, we were talking before things got started. Like, I don't know. I feel like for people our age, like the year 2000 always feels very recent.
Yeah.
And it's like anything post 2000 happened very recently, where like the reality is there are college students that were not alive at that time. Like,
right.
Many college
right.
students that were not alive at that point.
Right. The year 2000 mentally always seems like the fixed point. 20 years ago is 1980. No, that's 40 years ago. So a game from 2007 still sits in the brain as something from the future, but it was 14 years ago.
Yeah. All right, so where are we going? Are we going Port Town, Forest of
straight
the
down.
Lost?
No.
Well,
no,
yes,
no.
That's true enough. I'm actually going to turn down our... it sounds kind of loud.
Turn it up. Yeah. Well, I guess it decided for us.
We were
Lake
too
Shore.
We were too slow.
This is a great game. Every level's awesome.
What is that? He's...
What? Is he...
He's like beating a dragon with a pipe.
That's all he had. What would you do?
Okay.
All right. Yeah, I completely forget how to play this game.
Oh, no. Oh my god! What the hell is going on?
No, it's very easy to follow. We're shooting at the shiny things and avoiding the other shiny things.
Okay. So,
oops. That,
as we're going to the right here at the speed of light, it took me a while to figure out how to even look in that direction.
That was another thing we talked about before, was how like, oh, you don't play a game for 14 years and suddenly it's real, real hard to remember.
Right. Well, I feel like when this first came out, this was like a magical little gem that you found.
Yes.
And turned me on to. And Mike can tell you, I hate video games.
That's why he's on this show.
Right. But every now and again, one will come out that I'm just completely obsessed with right from the first sitting, and this was one of those.
Yeah, whoops, I keep losing track of this.
I'm looking at your character.
I don't think I've gotten hit yet, though, which is, whoa, I don't know.
Someone's taken damage.
Yeah.
1 point.
You know a game is well...
Oh,
geez.
There it is. That's...
Is that a cow?
No.
It's Mary.
It's a cow with that's shooting
oh, God.
Rubik's cubes.
What's the button for the bomb?
It's Y.
Okay.
Top button.
Oh, my God. This is like...
Don't worry. This is going to be our most coherent video yet.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Spoilers, Paul, for the rest of this video. That's the most normal boss of the game.
Oh, by far. Yeah, by far. Yeah, so this is made by Cave. Graveyards.
Yeah, let's go to Graveyard. Wow, you got to do all of them.
Do you?
Yeah, I think so.
I don't 100% know about that, but I, again, it's been probably 14 years since I've played this. Desecrate the Graves.
Just a day ago.
Yeah, exactly. So yeah, this is made by Cave, who have a reputation for, oh god, they've got some really complicated like lineage with space shooters, Japanese space shooters. But in short, they're kind of the company that that really leaned into the bullet hell genre of shooter.
As you can see.
Yeah, and I will say, like, I've played many, many Cave games, and this is by far their least complicated. There's sheep coming.
Oh no.
Ugh. What is that? I can't even. That man was so covered by the bullets that he was shooting and taking that I couldn't even see what he was.
Classic American.
Whoa. And it's always, you know, it's a sign of good game design when the game itself has to have a blinking red arrow pointing you towards the enemies, because otherwise they will just get completely lost in the background.
Oh, there he is.
It's Barry Baron Jordan. Oh no, Michael Jordan.
I enjoy how it announces who the bosses are, because nobody would have freaking clue.
Oh, wait till the end, man.
Yeah, don't give him any spoilers.
Yeah, no spoiler. What the hell? What is...
God, poor Barry. Right,
Oh no.
Yeah, no, like...
This is a bit too intense to jump back into Team Brothership with. I don't know what we were thinking.
Yeah, I was gonna, like, originally when we were talking...
I've been gone for 4 weeks because I've been sick, and look at this shit.
I was gonna, like, have the beginning of this episode just be this, like, elaborate backstory for where you've been for so long, but it's like, no time for that! We need all them... okay, I guess you're right. You do double back. For some reason, I've forgotten the man fighting the dragon on top of the train. I've been watching Baccano lately, so people fighting on the roofs of trains is very familiar.
There's our Halloween pumpkin. This is Halloween Town.
I thought you were going to say there's your Halloween pig. This is all Halloween. I mean, that's...
Yeah. I mean, it's a brilliant Halloween-themed game, but so far I haven't been able to see anything other than projectiles.
Which is pretty standard for Cave. Yeah, I'm trying to think. I've played a couple of their other games. I mean, I've played most of the ones that have been released in English, and I've imported a few of the others. Yeah, they're kind of they're right on that. Whoa, they're right on that cusp of being bearable.
Was that a chef pig a minute ago?
There's been like tons of chef pigs. Ooh, I took a hit there.
I just haven't been able to see them through all the chaos.
Yeah.
Oh no.
I don't really even really see most of the enemies. I just see, like, explosions.
Well, rest assured, they're very cool design. They look very... you said about Halloween Town. Everybody here is pretty Nightmare Before Christmas.
Yeah, no joke. This is a fantastic-looking game. The sprite work is awesome. But, like, can't see a whole heck of a lot when you got two-player...
Hundred Reaper Death
10,000 projectiles on the screen at the same time.
And I'll admit, so Cave... I like space shooters, but Cave has had a tendency. Oh, jeez.
That's what the bomb's for.
Oh, good call. Oh, wow, he died pretty quick. Cave has had a tendency, as time has gone by, to lean further into the, like, little girls in sketchy outfits. And Deathsmiles, at the time of its release, seem to be, like, really down with that. And so I actually put off... I had bought some of the other Cave games, but I put off getting this one for a while until I found it just, like, real cheap, and I was like, whatever. But actually, compared to some of their other games, this one feels a lot less sketchy, and, like, the enemy designs and the characters that you run into, it's got really kind of a Castlevania feel to it, honestly.
Yeah. Single-player mode also has a story, which is, like, not legit, but it's pretty funny.
You died, dude.
Oh.
That shows peak game when you don't even know that you died.
Yeah, just keep talking, because, whoa.
Yeah, but the single-player mode on this is pretty good, too. Yeah. It's all the same levels. Oh, there is a bit of a story, but the game has a few things going on. Oh God!
There we go.
Thank you. What?
he died and it blew up most of the rest of the forest.
Seriously. Those are some pretty structurally sound trees and ruins.
Can we go through? We can't. So how the hell do we...
Up.
Okay.
Oh, my...
Oh, jeez. Oh, sorry. Yeah.
Oh, you can't touch the rocks?
Oh, I'm looking at you again. Jesus.
You can touch... Oh, you can touch them, but you can't get past them.
Right.
All right, something's going on.
Oh, definitely got to kill the minivan.
Yeah, absolutely. That's... Ah, damn. Saw that coming. That's
what's his name. It's the van down by the river.
Oh, it's Chris Farley. Oh, poor Chris Farley. Oh, here's a story.
Witch of the Swamp.
That's how cutscenes ought to be.
Yeah.
Oh,
I think
no.
My character is supposed to be like some kind of yokel.
Did you just say Yoko?
Yes, my character is supposed to be the wife of John Lennon, who debatably ruined the Beatles.
Let's be honest, somebody had to ruin the Beatles. What is this?
Oh, come on! She crashed into me.
I'm just using these bombs, I don't care.
I mean, got them for some reason. She's,
there we go. Oh, and just plummets right into the river.
So she's French. She's your classic yokel.
Yeah. Sacre bleu! Where is my Miller Lite?
That's cultural appropriation, but I don't know on whose side it is.
I must put on my finest V-neck white T-shirt to go to the dive bar and watch the game. I'm too distracted with my French mumblings to focus on killing spiders.
Yeah, I'm paying full attention right, here, and I still don't know what's going on.
The levels do get hard. They do get harder as you go along, too, regardless of what order you do them in. Don't forget to take your finger off the fire button so that the power-ups flow towards you. That's classic Cave.
Thank you for telling me now. Not half an hour ago.
Well, it's not like the score really matters. Oh. I don't think we're going to be getting onto the leaderboards after this one.
No. Not when they've been shut down for 10 years.
What? No, they're coming up behind me.
Oh, no.
Is that just like a giant island?
Yeah. Well, I think they're like the giant bug things from like Princess Mononoke. Oh, not Princess Mononoke, Nausicaa. Sorry, I was forgetting my, God damn.
Nope, using the bomb.
I think we both did.
Oh.
Don't worry, I can almost see what's going on. Now you're just shooting. There's nothing even there.
There's literally not going to be a... it's Old Man Willow.
It's Wispy Woods.
Wispy Woods. There's literally going to not be a single usable screenshot for when I make the thumbnail for this video.
This is Wispy Woods after he's lost his job.
God, what the
it's
hell?
Been out.
They're apples. Apples of Doom. Like that's, in Snow White.
That's your screenshot.
Yeah. Oh my
Your screenshot
God.
Literally
oh
just
god, he's not dead.
No!
I totally just took my finger off the controller. I thought that was it.
Holy
Do you have a bomb?
Oh god.
There we go.
Jeez Louise. Wow.
Didn't he just like blow up everywhere and he just kept going? What is this? This is not even one of the bad bosses.
No, they get way worse. Oh, man, and you were worried about playing this game tonight. The Beast Awakens. This isn't the last level, is it?
No. We got a good to go.
Yeah, I think I remember.
I love this game, but I I can't have any commentary playing it other than what is going on. I've been talking about this one for a while, and all I can say now is like, what? Oh, no.
Yeah. Oh, there's...
Oh, lots of enemies. Oh.
Yeah, there's...
What the hell?
How do I get down there?
Skeletons. Oh, my God. Yeah, which... Well, all right, I'll go this way, you go that way.
This... Oh.
Just gotta do it fast.
Jeez.
There's like crippling slowdown right now, but it's the only thing keeping us alive.
Yeah, well, I'm dead, I think.
No, because it sped up again. Yeah, and like I said, no joke, if we should play like Akai Katana or something.
We should not.
Or Pink Sweets. Or they just released Limited Run is doing Mushisame, the one with all the bugs.
Oh, God.
All right, everything's on fire. Oh. I don't know what direction we can go in.
When I don't know what's going on, I just throw a bomb. Hope for the best.
Why is everything on
fire? Now that I've died so many times, I should ask, do we have limited continues?
All right, my character just took a hit, but I
think
don't
know.
I
think it's the fire.
Oh, God. Okay.
See?
Yeah.
Oh, all right. And there's bullets in the fire.
Of course there are bullets in the fire.
Oh, God. Which way is it coming, and what is... I think it's Cerberus or something, isn't it?
No, it's a double dragon.
Oh, okay.
Double dragon?
God of Flames, yeah. That'll be our next video, Paul. You and I can play Double Dragon 4 again.
Christ. Oh, God.
So... For people paying attention...
All two of you.
There's nobody.
The God of Fire is on equal level to a big cow in this game.
I mean, it was a really big cow.
Right, has name and everything.
Yeah. I think they take more damage in the head. Just like real people. I don't like any of this.
The bombs are for.
I don't think they're gonna blow up those rocks, though.
I'm trying to blow it up. Forget the rocks. Oh, I'm in trouble.
His head's through the rock. It's almost gone.
All right,
there we go.
Good lord.
And I thought the slowdown was just on my end from having it streaming. But
no, yeah, it's. I'm really glad we're recording on this side because I think this would be unusable if we were trying to like. Stream out to you in some way. Oh,
now we're entering the end game.
I was gonna make a joke, but there was nothing appropriate that I could say. You following all this, Paul?
Yes. Completely. Between the slightly translated words and the chaos that's every level.
My character is the strong, silent type.
Ah. You gotta help this person, Sakura.
Yeah.
That's well, about as far as I got.
Now that we're Hades Castle, or...
That's the terrible...
Or Gurg. Gorge.
That's the terrible extra level. You don't need to beat that to beat the game. That's the end of the game.
All right,
that's probably gonna murder us.
I mean, we kind of have to, right?
Good old Gorg.
Gorg. Game's only like 5 levels long, so. Oh, this is this is Cerberus, right? Oh, these things have the suicide bullets. That's right. Every time you kill an enemy, they shoot stuff at you and they die.
Yeah. This is going to be bad.
Yeah. Well, so much for our high scores. Cripes.
Or chef pigs.
No.
And tanks.
Oh, I do not like this. Oh, no.
Can you only shoot left to right, or can you shoot up and down?
Only left and right. Like God intended. How many bombs do I have? Not enough.
Yeah.
I think that was it for me, actually. Ah, oh, crap. Yeah, I took a hit there. Not a whole lot left.
Don't you usually, like, travel down in a gorge, not up?
Only if you're a chump. Whoa, that was close.
I'm just losing these bombs.
Oh, damn it.
Well, that was your first death, though.
I know.
Oh, but... now minotaurs with spears. This is great.
Big dog.
Oh.
Whoa.
He's not. Is this the boss already?
No. I think there's a second one.
It's like a mini boss.
Yeah. Whoa.
But looking at it from my side, you all would have taken so much damage. It looks like you're avoiding the stuff, but it...
Whoa. Watch out for the suicide bullets. Yeah, oh, see, man. the little heart in the center of your character is the only part that has to actually avoid anything. What the... Okay.
You gotta blow that up.
How? Ah, damn it.
Not good.
Whoa.
Now, knowing that heart thing would have been good to know at the beginning of this.
Yeah, people figured it out, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Our viewers understood. They're a perceptive group. They're very... Whoa. Okay, you can move through those, so that's good.
Perfect.
This is fine. It's fine.
I like the rock elevators from the giant ogres.
Oh, man.
All they're trying to do is get to Mordor. Not Mordor. Moria. The mine.
Yeah, exactly. You can tell that this level's a little bit different because the banter is tapered off.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh.
Whoa. Ah. How was I supposed to avoid that?
What the hell?
Spiders.
Teleporting spiders.
Yeah, I hope there's no arachnophobes watching this episode. That's going to be kind of rough. Or kind of great.
Don't worry, they're friendly spiders.
Yeah, exactly. Spiders are our friends. Didn't everybody read that...
Charlotte's Web.
Strange Planet comic? Oh yeah, Charlotte's Web, exactly. The spiders are just there to tell everyone else how great you are.
Oh, man, I wish that was true.
Oh, spiders are just everybody's hype, man.
Yeah.
You're like, this is the boss, ooh, right?
Yeah. I think it's just a repaint of the dragon.
Oh.
I was going to say, isn't that just the same thing you just fought?
Oh, wait, what is that? What is that?
Oh. Oh, there's two dragons.
No.
An immediate bomb.
Yeah,
yeah, we should
just dual bomb there.
Yeah. We should probably try to, like, time these out in some way.
Alright, you go.
I think that was my last one. Whoa, hi there.
I have no idea if I have any more. There we go.
We almost got him.
Almost dead.
Yeah, well, if you
almost
just
actually see
constantly
it.
Throw bombs at the boss, maybe that'll do something.
What?
I don't know how you guys are playing this right now. I can't even see what the hell's anything.
It's easy. You just, you know, you just watch what you're doing and move forward. So I got a game over at the beginning of this level, but I somehow ended it with a higher score than I went into it.
It's because there's like 10 million points in that level. Did you see all that nonsense? There was more in that level than the entire game up till now. In comparison, we're not even going to have to play the last level here.
I hope we get three other people to help us.
Oh, man, that's bound to make it more visible.
Yeah, it's just like a screen of bullets. This is either going to be our best episode or our worst.
That's like every episode.
Oh, yeah, I'm pretty sure we say that every time.
And we're always right. It's that French yokel again. Oh, suicide bullets. I thought we already...
Now has to fight every boss all over again.
Yeah, just like in Night Slashers.
But they don't actually have health.
No.
Oh, now you have to put... He exploded into mini ones. Oh god, now there's two of them. And now you're somehow in a castle?
The level was called the Hades Castle. At least when you get hit, it, like, clears the screen of some of this crap. So you can't just get, like, stun-locked. Ah! Not really sure how it feels.
Famous last words.
Yeah. Oh, good lord. And again, I still stand by what I said earlier. This is a lot more coherent than Cave's later games.
That's saying something.
I mean, yeah, this... Did I get a game over again? Damn it. I'm falling apart now.
You're yokeling too much.
Oh. Yeah.
I just passed the legendary 666 for the points. I feel like that should do extra damage.
Oh, it's giant eyeballs. There's actually some pretty cool music going on, too, if you can hear it over the sound of gunfire.
Now, this is not a game for hearing or seeing things.
It's about feeling.
Right.
What we're feeling is deep frustration because we don't know what the hell's going on.
That's how video gaming was in 2007.
Oh, yeah, no.
There she is.
Oh, jeez, come on. How was I supposed to see? I didn't even see that.
Was that it?
I think so.
Wow.
Game's over. We win. Ah, these suicide bullets. We should have turned those off.
Half the fun, if they weren't there, you'd be able to see.
Yeah. Well, we can't have that.
Seeing's overrated. I would have turned them up in video games.
Ah, there's knights.
I don't even know where I am right now.
Like, in the game or metaphorically?
Nah, both.
I hear you. After this week, I hear you. What is
your grand entrance in the ballroom?
I am pretty surprised I managed to avoid all of that. Yeah, so I mean, even the size of... Ah, damn it. With the size of your character, like, your hitbox is actually pretty small.
Broke the chandelier and the statues.
We're just the worst.
You guys don't have a lot to pay for.
Yeah, we're not getting our damage deposit back on this place. Ah, I saw that coming. Whoops, watch out. Enough of this.
Oh, no, it's really skipping on my end.
No, that's part of the game. Yeah. That's all how it goes.
It's a feature.
Well, that's the great thing when you're making a game like this. Oh god. You don't actually have to make it real well, because if you like mess it all up and you create lots of slowdown, you're actually helping your players anyway, so it discourages good game design. Whoa.
Yeah, you definitely belong in a AAA game PR department after that bit of nonsense.
Come on, EA. You've got my resume. And my fan letters. All about how great Dragon Age 2 is. Whoa. Oh, come on.
Yeah, there's a bit more Castlevania-inspired enemies in this level if you're able to see any of them.
It's a big
mess. And I see also just increasing the size of the enemies makes them different.
Exactly. And changing the color, too.
Yes.
It's classic game design, too. Whoa.
Here's the next boss. It's the last boss.
Last level.
Oh, you get to just murder a bunch of people in a ball.
A bunch of dancers.
Oh, yeah, what is going on?
Some Super Castlevania 4 here. Yeah.
Ugh, they make like a squish sound when you kill them.
Yeah, just like real dancers.
Oh, God.
All right. I was gonna try to dodge that. I'm just like,
not putting up with that.
Nope. God, stop throwing things at us, please. See, that's why we gotta shoot the dancers, because if we didn't kill them, they'd kill us. Whoa! My cat has become
overwhelmed. Your cat, like, attacking the screen?
Yeah.
Or has it just gone into, like, an epileptic seizure on the floor?
Yeah, he just kind of spazzed out. He's running around attacking the floor. He got overstimulated by the on-screen action.
I feel overstimulated by the on-screen action.
Here he is. This is it.
This is the best last boss of any video game.
Jebediah, the Amish father.
Jitterbug.
Close. You were close.
Like, it's so much better.
He's got a flaming staff, I mean.
It's gone mad, I say. A little bit of light child abuse.
Yeah.
That's how you know he's a bad guy.
Exactly.
A real jerk.
Oh, we do have to fight this guy first, that's right. Ugh. What did he even shoot me with?
His flaming staff.
I didn't even... Oh, okay. They give you a lot of bombs in this game.
I could use a few more. If I see too much nonsense on screen, I'm just pressing the bomb button. Whoa.
Whoa. Oh, God.
Bomb.
Well, at least those were in waves that were kind of observable. They weren't just like clouds of garbage.
He punched me.
I think I just crashed into him like an idiot.
I mean, why is this guy attacking me? Right. He could be building really good furniture.
Is he dead? Where is he?
He's still got a third of his health left.
Oh no. Oh no. Oh,
he's doing something bad now. I don't like that.
He is not taking a lot of damage very quickly.
No. What is going on?
Oh.
We gotta get him before he does that one more time.
Oh my god.
How many bombs do you have?
I think we actually... He's almost gone. We just got a bunch
There he goes.
Just crashes into the ground.
Ugh, herk. I'm gonna start using that when I stub my toe. Ah, herk.
See, All Hallows Eve. Your character really likes to call people jerks.
It's a good insult.
Oh, man.
Oh, my God. Poor jitterbug.
He's not doing the jitterbug anymore. He's doing the jitterbug with Jesus.
There he is!
Tyranno Satan.
Oh my god. This is just about as good as the giant Satan robot we fought the other day.
Yeah! It all comes back to giant Satan. He's the classic horror villain.
Why have I not figured that out by now?
Oh, I'm hitting a button. You
remember at the end of Halloween when Michael Myers took his mask off and he was a giant robot Satan dinosaur? Or at the end of Christine when they opened up the hood of the car and out climbed a giant robotic Satan dinosaur?
When I first played this, seeing that Tyranno Satan was secretly behind it all was one of the best reveals in all of video games.
I don't know if we've actually hit him for the last little while, because he's got those damn blocks in the way. He actually is taking damage fairly quickly, but he keeps putting crap in the way.
Now, does he have, like... Oh, no, it's his shoulder. Never mind. It looked like he was, like, spitting out another head.
I mean, like you do sometimes. That's like, what was that Uninvited? That movie where the cat has the other cat inside?
Oh.
No.
Now, right in the face. He's above us. He's found our weakness. We can't shoot up.
This is ridiculous.
We almost got him.
You just need more bombs.
Yeah, we got a lot.
Oh, there we go.
Wait, did he
Jebediah
spit out?
Flew out.
Oh, he spit out Jitterbug. Okay. Oh, now he's down to just the neck.
Satan snake. Giant Satan robot snake.
I mean, that was in the Bible. That's where Satan came from.
Yes, that's where they drew their inspiration from.
I mean, this game has a lot of biblical allusions.
I mean, Mary the cow.
Exactly, the pig chef.
I'm pretty sure that's some type of blasphemy, Paul. I don't know what that is, but I don't think Francis would want to hear that one.
It cuts to the Vatican. Pope Francis is playing Deathsmiles as well. This game rules. We did it, everybody. We did it. It's time to go back to the real world.
Everything's all hazy. I think that's just my eyes from watching this. Wait, I thought Sakura died. How is she back?
He didn't kill her. He slapped her around a little bit.
Oh.
Now he's abandoning her to
God.
Go back to the real world.
This guy is a jerk. John's character's right.
Well, I gotta throw something at my cat. He's undeterred.
Does her head have teeth?
Yes.
It's got a face.
Oh, man.
You mean your heads don't?
I wish.
We're gonna get hit with another copyright claim because we're not talking enough for me letting this pop song play in the background.
Oh man! Oh, we can.
Whoever
do...
owns
it. Oh, we gotta make a choice. Are we going
we're
back
going,
to the real?
We're going home.
Screw this! I'm out of here. Sick of these pig chefs and giant mutant cows and Tyrannosaurus Satans. So long, assholes.
Seriously. You see that giant head I had to fight in the ground? Forget this place.
Oh, I love this. And now they're just like hanging out in crappy bars. Like, remember when we gave up being magical, like super magical witches for this crap? Jeez, just lay the guilt on a little bit.
Thank you, game, for telling me I made the wrong choice.
Oh, okay. The end.
They only talk about one of you? The other character doesn't matter?
There she is.
Okay.
I thought I was going to say pass safely away. Yeah. Like, wow, that was a dark ending.
Oh yeah, isn't that this game has this real whack story that it's like little girls who die wind up in this magic world or something? I don't know.
I enjoy the woman in the background's face. She's like, I'm back, and everybody's like, no, now we have to pay college tuition.
Wait, what was that about somebody's eyes brimming
this
with evil?
This guy with the hat on, he ran away because he was doing something sketchy.
Awesome.
Well, I'm not really sure what else we can say after that.
I mean, I think the title of the game will basically be what people feel. They'll either eye after watching it, or during watching it, maybe, or smile that we actually went through all that chaos.
not like a rigid smile of excitement, but just like a slight warm knowing smile. They'll nod at their screen, and then drink a bottle of dish cleaner, climb into bed.
Well, I'm going to go climb back into my sarcophagus, and I won't see either of you guys again for weeks and weeks now.
No, we got all sorts of fun stuff coming up. We're going to do Fight Crab and Stubbs the Zombie. We'll do some more pizza challenges. It's going to be great. It's going to be great. All right, everybody. Well, thanks for joining us here. I think we had a good time. Well, I mean, maybe. So until oh geez, we didn't even introduce ourselves this episode. This came started buck wild. Oh, and we get to.
Oh, here you go. Now you can.
All right, I know everybody's gonna find out what my last name is again. Yeah, we started this stuff right out of the gate. So yeah, until next time, I've been Mike.
And I'm Paul.
I'm John. Later, everyone.
Bye. See ya.